5. Got this winter storm coming in. Roads got a little better this morning as the sun came out, but now a mixture of rain and freezing rain moving into the air. And most of the impacts now are going to be on trees, power lines, and exposed surfaces. But the sleet and slush, whatever you want to call it, that's left over from the storm earlier in the week, will continue to be very, very slippery. And temperatures probably not going to budge much at all this evening. Just hang around that 32, 33 degree mark. There's been some pretty significant icing. Madison County, Yazoo, western parts of Hines, Vicksburg, and down into Natchez, southwest Mississippi, even Copiah County's had some ice. And in western Rankin County, trees and stuff like that are getting a nice glaze on them as well. Here's the situation. Really, I will highlight that highest accumulation of ice is really looking like it's going to take shape right in this area, down from Natchez up to the west of Jackson into the southern parts of Yazoo County. So final total is probably going to end up in the quarter to three-quarter inch total north of a Natchez-Jackson-Carthage line with that very slushy mush, I'm going to call it, left over from all the rain. And we've got some pretty heavy rainfall totals, too. There could be some flash flooding. You're getting runoff from the sleet and ice. And there could be some flooding from that. So here it is, the final totals. This is what the computer sees anyway, for ice accretion across the area. And as we head into the morning time, we'll probably begin to see a little bit of leftover shower activity. So here's the situation. Take you through the evening time. You can see the big area of rain and notice those temperatures hovering right around 32, 33 degrees. And by 8, 10 o'clock, it all begins to shift out of the area. Overnight temperatures probably going to hang in the upper 20s and lower 30s. I don't think it'll change too much, but tomorrow is going to be a blustery and cold day. Cloudy, there could be a passing rain shower, a little freezing rain, sleet mix in. I think anything we get tomorrow will just kind of be a nuisance type shower. The melt will continue to be slow. Still looking at our frigid air mass slowly beginning to move out. This is the disturbance moving through. We got a significant weather pattern change that is going to begin to take place next week. A little warmer this weekend, but a lot warmer for next week. Something to look forward to. So the departing storm, as we head through tomorrow, as I said, some residual leftover light showers of rain, freezing rain, maybe some snow flurries, but thawing really begins on the weekend as we start to get up into the upper 40s. We'll see some 50s, and next week 60s are on the board. So rain and freezing rain will be ending during the late evening hours. Temperatures holding pretty close to 32 degrees. Tomorrow 37. I'll keep the exclamation point up because there's still going to be some icy road conditions, especially in the morning. We should see some melting through the day, additional melting. But in a lot of areas, it will be slow to melt. And then tomorrow night, we could have more black ice freeze-up problems, 23. Here's your 7-day forecast. Sunshine Friday and Saturday really going to help things in melting. And you see temperatures rise. A cold front brings some showers. Sunday night into Monday, look at Tuesday and Wednesday. Bring it on.